for this main event. Calvin Kattar. He is a plus 240 underdog against the favorite, Zabit Magomedsharipov, at minus 300. Maximum 3 5-minute rounds in the featherweight division for this main event. Tonight's Fight Clock is brought to you by Dave and Buster's. If you need a reminder, Kattar in the blue, Zabit in the gray. Look out for the boxing of Kattar and the very fluid, unorthodox and creative striking of Magomedsharipov.
Double jabs and inside low kicks to start with. Zabit switches to southpaw, maybe opens up the body kick for him.
This main event is only 3 rounds. Magomedsharipov's team decided to make that call. It wasn't discussed with him.
Ooh. And that's one of the weapons. Kattar has a beautiful right hand straight down the middle.
Well, Kattar spoke about the style of Zabit and said he does all the stuff that my coach would tell me off for if I was to do that in the octagon. He says basics win rounds, and that's what he's sticking to.
There's that long jab, too. Really twists his whole body into it, which sets up his right hand even better. Because it's turning into it.
And he does a good job of covering himself as he's throwing the jab as well. You see everything's very tight. You know, he guards the left side of his chin with his left shoulder, and the right side of his chin is tucked behind his hand. So it allows him to push himself into range without feeling like he's at too much risk. Then he can uncork that right hand over the top. There it is.
I saw a really nice analysis of Kattar's boxing by Brendan Dorman. He really highlighted a few nuances, particularly the way that he goes to the body and how he does so without the risk that a lot of people normally do. Ooh. But he's going to need to have his wits about him tonight.
Nice. That was lovely. A double jab step through to southpaw through the right hand over the top. Good head movement by Kattar.
Yeah, and he's staying very calm in there. Not getting overwhelmed by the fancy stuff that Zabit is capable of doing. But you see right there, Zabit's also capable of just standing in there and trading with you in a boxing range as well.
But that Chris Fishgold versus Kattar fight just showed me how good Kattar was at being under fire, but still being able to make offensive decisions as well as covering.
Yes.
And not putting himself at risk. It was incredible stuff.
Confidence in his guard. You know, he can keep his eyes open because he knows his guard's there, so he can watch for opportunities.
Oh. Big uppercut just missed there from Kattar.
Something chatting to Mark Henry last week in New York, he said that they've got to nullify the jab of Kattar. They know that that's the most dangerous weapon because of it. You can see how he's trying to... Oh, nice front kick of Zabit. But there's so much variety coming back in his direction, it's difficult for him to start his rhythm yet. Kicks, switch stances, long punches as well from Zabit. Uses his reach so well. Nice low kick.
Yeah. Beautiful low kick from Kattar.
13 fight winning streak for Zabit. These fighters have both had the same number of visits to the octagon. Zabit takes away the base of Kattar, and that step through, so lovely.
Nice left hand there from Kattar as Zabit was stepping in. I like that he's mixing in these leg kicks as well.
Zabit brought in former world champion Kermit Cintron and other boxers, brought a lot of value to his camp. Apparently, we've only seen about 40% of Zabit's ability, he told us.
I was going to ask that. I forgot what the percentage was.
Very low, which is very exciting.
Nice.
See, I like how he switches, but when he switches, he's something out in front of you. You know, he's already throwing a punch and then switching.
Oh, an elbow to body shot.
Nice comp. Counter coming back there from Kattar.
Zabit already with a higher volume, higher output.
Well, it's his range control, too, his distance control. Because he's landing these kicks, moving, staying at distance, whereas for Calvin Kattar, he's got to get in closer to use his hand. Ooh, nice overhand right. These guys are trading. Oh, high knee.
And you know, for as dynamic as Kattar is, as Zabit is as a martial artist, he doesn't mind getting into a firefight, does he? I mean, there's no real reason. reason for him to be standing in the pocket training.
Oh, nice uppercut from Keita. We're going to go on a short break. Back in 30 seconds. Ready for round number two. Give us some more. That was great in the first. And they get straight to work. The number 11 versus the number 5 in the featherweight division. The title is being contested very soon. Max Holloway and Alex Volkanovski.
We saw a lovely exchange of combinations at the end of that round as well. Both of these guys have got a lot to offer in the boxing range.
Oh, we can hear Keita's support base being heard here, led by his mum, no doubt.
Kick comes up the centre for Keita. A little bit smothered, though, as the beat standing so close to him. At a range that I wasn't expecting fighting from.
I thought we'd have some takedowns mixed in at this point as well.
Mm-hmm. Well, he has 26 takedowns, which is the same as Frankie Edgar. So he's doing some serious numbers already.
Who he also said is his favorite training partner. You can imagine the pace that those two guys set in a sparring session.
It'd be like a couple of squirrels in just wrestling practice, wouldn't it?
Those moments where you see Zabit move, you can't help but kind of freeze up for a moment, try and figure out what's coming in your direction.
Well, it's funny you should say that, because Keita speaks about reactions. He said, if I have to think, I'm too slow. I've just got to react to everything.
Yeah, but in MMA, that's the thing in MMA. You can't react to everything. There's always a target open somewhere, and Zabit has such diversity to his game that, you know, you cover your head and your body and he's going to attack a leg.
Let's open up the corner audio on the blue side. New England Cartel, Rob Font and Coach Tyson.
Follow the cross now, follow the cross. Yes,
let's get our jab going, come on.
You can't throw enough jabs, Calvin. You can't throw enough jabs. Yeah. Keep fading, please, keep fading.
Let's get back to our jab, Calvin. Yes,
Bring your feet.
So Mark Henry was right when he spoke to you about the jab, Dan. Definitely going to be the weapon that they have to look out for.
And I do wonder whether that's why they're trying to stand so close to him. Because Keita's got such a long jab, I wonder whether they think by smothering the jab, it's going to make him hesitant to throw it a little. Because he likes that double jab pump right hand, and he needs a little distance for that.
Space, for sure. First takedown attempt there from Zabit. Good defense from Keita, but you could tell Zabit wasn't overly committed to it. He was kind of feeling it out, putting it out there.
Mind of Zabit, look at that. Straight onto the back.
That's his trick.
Lovely control there, but great.
Level contest, ladies and gentlemen.
I also got the impression, speaking to Keita earlier this week, that he feels like the longer this fight goes, the more effective he can be against Zabit.
Yeah, but here we are with what? A minute and a half. Round two. The numbers all Zabit.
Doubled the strikes of Keita so far.
Well, I mean, I am impressed with that takedown defense from Calvin Keita.
Nice right hand on the top. And a jab to follow. Check the inside low kick.
It's just hard to get numbers going on a guy like Zabit with the movement and the diversity of attacks that he's going to hit you with.
Yeah, and he's doubling up the volume of Keita at the moment. 27 to 52 for Zabit. Significant strikes landed.
And the footwork and defense of Keita is holding up, and I do feel like he's starting to gain some momentum here.
Oof.
That was a nice left hook from Zabit. Prime with that jab.
Oh, hold on.
Very nice.
And when you consider all of the other guys from Dagestan that we've seen this evening, none of them fight like Zabit. He is an anomaly.
Nobody fights like Zabit, not unless you're watching Crouching Tiger.
Well, he's a kung fu guy, right? He's a wushu sambo guy.
Uh-huh.
And we have one champion who possesses a similar skill set, which doesn't quite have the wrestling just yet.
That movement from Zabit, right by the left hook.
Hey!
Oh.
Give him the water. Both those rounds were closed.